So we're gonna go ahead and start doing the shock towers and get it ready to get all primed up and paint it by today. Hopefully by today. No promises, but hopefully we get it done by today. Okay guys, so I already sanded it down super smooth. Don't mind the overspray of primer, but remember there was a big giant hole like right here. Well, it's long gone. And then I already masked everything up. The whole car is pretty masked up. The only thing I have to mask up is the hood, and then I'm gonna clean up the, wipe everything down before I start shooting. Yeah, hopefully this video, man, hopefully this video, we get this car painted. That's the plan for today. Alright guys, so I just got done sanding everything down. It's super smooth. I'm just gonna wash all the dust off, and then we'll start putting base on this color. And then after that, we'll just clear it, and then should be good. And then after I'm done with this, I'm gonna go ahead and start doing the motor. So I'll see you guys in a bit. Alright guys, so we just got the bay painted, and it looks super, oh my god, looks super good. I just used a cheap Harbor Freight, I think 30 bucks gun, and damn, that should look good. Here, let me give you guys a closer look up. I hope Darren, if you're watching this, I hope you're happy, bro. I went above and beyond. I don't even know what the hell I'm doing, but at least we did it, so check it out. Okay, so now, since I already painted the bay, it's time to start working on the rack and pinion. So maybe by tomorrow, which is my day off, we could bolt it up. We could start messing with the engine, and then, yeah, it looks pretty good so far. Right now, I'm about to go to San Jose to pick up some headers. And then maybe come back, and hopefully this engine bay is dried up. But I'm really, really, really happy of how it came out. It looks really good for an amateur. You see what I'm saying? Anybody could do it. Just takes time. But yeah. Good morning, guys. Today is the next day when I just finished the paint job, and oh my God, there's another fire. There's two fires. Oh my God, dude, look at this. That's a new fire. That was the first fire. Now this is the second fire. Oh man, these bums, I swear, man. Cause there's a river back there, there's bums living back there, and bro, that just started. That was already ending, now this is starting again. Well, anyways, oh my god, I did a pretty decent job. I hope you're happy, Darren, because I'm happy that this came out good. One shot, no runs. I mean, there might be little orange peel here and there, like over there, but a little buff here and there, it works out. Yep, so now this is done and said, I'm gonna start working on this. I'm gonna start taking off the clutch. I'm gonna take off the harness. Hopefully the flywheel is still good. Let's see, we have to go get a new belt for this. I'm gonna have to measure that up. We're gonna need a new oil filter. Oh, we got some headers. I'll show you guys that in a bit, but we do got some new headers. I just picked them up last night from San Jose. I drove all the way over there because we needed it. So yeah. But yeah guys, don't forget to subscribe. It does help out the channel a lot and it helps me out and it gives me more motivation to give you guys more videos. And it does mean a lot to me. It really, really does. So subscribe, it means a lot. And just look how nice this is now. Okay guys, so now I'm gonna start doing the loom on this motor. I am going to be ending this video with, hopefully it's done. Nah, it's not gonna be done. It's not gonna be done. It's too much work. But I do want to get like a rough draft of it so that I could start looming it up. But I think I might be able to do it today. We'll see, because I'm trying to get everything done because everything is taking so long. And going K-Series nowadays is really hard unless you have a lot of money. So I'll just put you guys on time-lapse. I'm not gonna show you guys how to do it because there's a video on it already, so you guys can go back and look at that. But for this, I'm just going to put you guys on time-lapse and go from there. So see you guys in a bit. Okay, so this is how the harness look like. It's gonna look different when I'm done with it. So I'm gonna go ahead and start on it. I'm gonna start cutting off all the looms, taking off all the brackets off. And yeah, I'll put you guys on time lapse and hopefully I get this done by today. And it's gonna look super nice. Hopefully it looks nice. I'm not gonna guarantee it looks nice, but I'm gonna try my best, like always. Okay, so far, I took mostly all those loom off and electric tape off, and now it looks like this. So it's gonna be like the same way I did on my hatch. If you guys want, you guys could go back and look at it, but exactly the same way. And then now I'm gonna just start depinning what I need to depin, and then I'll loom it up, and then I'll put the plug back in so I won't forget. Okay guys, so far I did all the single, double, triple wires on this side. I didn't loom this one up yet, but I did put like this electric cloth tape, which is really good. But I am going to loom this up. But remember that big giant wire? Well, I ran it through the valve cover, just like my old one. So if you want to know how I did it, it's the same thing as my old one, but I still got the rest to do. but it's looking good so far. But yeah guys, I'm gonna end the video here. Maybe the next video, I'll show you guys when it's fully done. It's gonna take a really long time and I don't want this video to be really, really long. So I'll see you guys on the next video. Thank you.